It's late 2020, and to say this year has been bizarre would be an understatement. With over 6 months of quarantine, not being allowed to go to the gym, the whole world shutting down, tens of millions of people losing their jobs, and now 120 degrees in Phoenix, I'm gonna spin a compass and just get on the road and see where it takes me. Preparedness is, you know, not just having supplies on hand, but knowing how to use them, training to use them. This company, Four Patriots, right here, they send me stuff occasionally. I do have their products that I've bought, like solar flashlights, you know, green powder, which is nutritious, and a whole bunch of other stuff. And that makes up a good chunk of my survival kit. I will be going to Northeast. I actually didn't expect Northeast at all.
I'm here to tell you that this actually works fairly well. You probably can't see it, but with a sleeping pad, sleeping bag or something like that, this is totally doable.
And inside that is going my cell phone charger. Partially waterproofs it, and then if I get into a situation where I need gloves, I also have gloves.
I'm in the forest at the Mogollon Rim camping by myself.
There's a thunderstorm rolling in. I've got some pre-made fire starters here, some underbrush. Challenge is everything's kind of wet right now. So we're gonna sprinkle some magnesium. All right, come on. Grow, fire, grow. I pre-made some cheddar tuna noodles. So here's the tuna, here's this. What we're gonna do first is boil the water. We're gonna get that going. The company Four Patriots sponsored this video, so fair warning, I'm not getting paid, I'm just reviewing their products. I love these power greens, I've actually been using them for years. So that's one thing I'm gonna be eating or drinking tomorrow. And then I got the survival radio specifically for this video that Four Patriots sent me for this trip, but I also don't know how this is gonna work legitimately.
Here is the northern Arizona weather. Hot temperatures and mostly dry conditions can be expected across much of northern Arizona through Sunday. Shower and thunderstorm chances will mainly be limited to the White Mountains, with only isolated storms possible elsewhere through Tuesday.
You hear that wind picking up? It's starting to rain. This is a good night. The water should be about boiling right now. Take that lid off, and then we're going to just pour it in my noodles. Now I'm just going to hold it right here, lay it down, let that cook a little bit more. This wind's really picking up. Look at this beautiful sunset. It does not get better than this, honestly. Now for the final touch, canned tuna. This is ready to go. Got protein, starch. It's delicious. The noodles are cooked perfectly. This is honestly one of the best meals I've ever had. I got some water going. I'm gonna add some walnuts, boil these, soften them up, and have that as a little addition to breakfast here. While that's going, I've got my Patriot power greens. And it's just green powder. Just dump it right on in there. Add in some water. That's what it looks like. And this, my friends, is a perfect, nutritious, delicious breakfast. Other than talking to you guys when I'm filming with my phone, the rest of the time it's totally off. I bought a paper atlas, a legit paper like road map. I don't know if you guys remember these. We're in at the Mogollon Rim. So I'm gonna take this highway up and then I'm gonna try to catch the 40 and we'll go towards Gallup, New Mexico. Then I have a feeling that we're going to Colorado today.
I saw something through the trees and want to show you guys this. Check this out. Slight change of plans. I am about 30 miles outside of a place called Pie Town, New Mexico, and I stopped at this little diner and met the owners who told me to go to these lava flows. I wrote down the instructions on a napkin, and that's where we're going now. Change of plans again. Some weather's coming in, so I went to Pie Town, New Mexico, and got a pie. And I gotta tell you guys, the gathering place right here is an awesome spot. I met the owners. They actually moved from Arizona, and this is their jam now. This is what they do. And if you guys go on the website, or actually find them on Instagram, the gathering place, they are going to be sending these pies all over the United States, the lower 48 to begin with. So go reach out to them on Instagram for more information. I just stopped at a little place past the Continental Divide, a hardware gas slash convenience store, pump gas at these really old, really cool pumps, and I got an ice cream sandwich, and this is the ice cream sandwich. It is a block of ice cream. I've never quite seen one like this. You eat it the same though. Well, that's something. I don't know if you can tell, but this is not camping. I noticed my windshield wiper got stuck when I was driving. You guys saw that and decided to come to Albuquerque and stay in the Hilton and take the car to the dealership tomorrow. So while I'm here, I don't want to spend outrageous prices on COVID food and delivery. So rather, I have my camping bag right here and tonight's dinner is super simple. This is a four bean salad. Some other options, I have some chili that I could cook up over a fire, you know, some Spam, other canned goods, and then obviously always Mrs. Dash original blend with no sodium. The thing that makes the New Mexico pie special is it's got apple, but it also has green chili in it because that's a New Mexico thing. And I've never had a pie at all with green chili. So let's see what this looks like. I'm very, very curious inside. So yeah, it's got that apple and the green chili right there. And that is so, so good. Somewhere here-ish, I think, in these mountains is a TWA aircraft that crashed a long time ago. Also, shout out to Larry Miller Hyundai. They hooked it up, they fixed my windshield wiper, and it works great. They didn't charge me, and they also replaced the battery in my key fob. Slow pedestrians, huh? What about fast ones? Yeah.
hiking right here. Who would have thought this is outside Albuquerque? So this is a beautiful alpine hiking trail and wilderness area. But there's this phenomenon that occurs. You'll notice these trees are bowing that way and this one's going this way. That's called flagging. And it's because the trees are going up straight, the wind blows them, and then they kind of go sideways like a flag. And that is all from high wind velocities that'll do that.
I've never found an empty wheelchair by itself, but I imagine that's not a good day. It's also probably not a good day finding a stroller just in the middle of the forest by itself.
Pretty good spot for a break right here with this beautiful view. Look at that.
This is the view of Albuquerque, and it is beautiful. Just pure oxygen. It's not Spaceballs brand, unfortunately, but it's still good to just rejuvenate and replenish. Now let's keep going.
If you didn't move, there's a finch over here. I guess he moved. I'm trying to feed this squirrel. He's playing hard to get. He keeps jumping tree to tree. But we've been playing this game with a nutrition bar for the last like 5 minutes. And ironically, the nutrition bar is over here. He just keeps jumping in the canopy.
Well, that riverbed took me to a trail, and that trail took me to a cabin. And the cabin overlooks everything. Interesting observation. Even when I'm more than 6 feet apart from people on the path, they get mad at me for not wearing my mask and the great outdoors with the wind blowing, but they will not pick up after their dog when there's a pile of, right in the middle of the path. That's not socially acceptable. Anyway, on to Denver.
I decided to take back roads and I'm doing this U-turn because I just saw something that we are going to. I hope that they're open. Boom, winery. Check that out. Grapevines right there. I'm following the sign, but it's sending me through the actual vineyards, which is, I have to admit, kind of cool.
So I kind of walked around, this place is closed, and ran into the owner who was working on this tractor. So I'm masking up, I'm going inside, and he's gonna give me a taste of some bottles that are open. So this is quite cool. And they got a nice little patio out here.
We're giving you tastings of more of a Mediterranean type grape.
Okay.
So Mediterranean grapes use wine, foods, the Mediterranean food is a lot of olive oils, light foods, that kind of thing, all right? And what we want to do is we want to embellish your tasting, right?
And so this is to cleanse your palate or to
So embellish? What this is going to do is going to do two things. This is a Marcona almond. It only grows in Spain.
Okay.
Marcona is one of the top nuts in the world. What I'd like for you to do is taste it right now. Get
Marcona,
an almond. That's a Marcona.
Almond.
Yeah. And it's a little bit more buttery.
Yeah.
A little bit kind of... So what I just did, believe it or not, is I just... Palate.
They call it a boutique winery. So I just surprised him and he was nice enough to open it up. It's a family run business. It's called the Casa Abril Vineyards, and that's because he and all his family were born between April 1st and April 15th. So Abril, and then they're also of Spanish descent. So they have the, Tempranillo wine that they brought in and these almonds from Spain. And they're really trying to just make this a Spanish authentic tasting.
Yeah, it's a Spanish grape.
Okay.
Okay. And what I did is I just aerated it for you a little bit, all right? Is you want to look at the wine. So you hold it by the stem.
By the stem so it doesn't warm up, right?
Look at the wine. Do is I want you to take a drink again. Mm-hmm. Not like a shot of tequila.
Okay. Chocolate
let
almond.
Let the chocolate kind of melt in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
And let it kind of sit and linger a little bit. While you do that, then I want you to taste it again. Let it linger in your mouth just a little bit. And let it go to the sides of your tongue because you have multiple taste buds.
That does enhance it quite a bit. That wine is amazing. It is the 2015 Tempranillo Grand Reserve.
The Zinfandel is a grape. A lot of people are familiar with Zinfandel as what they call white Zinfandel. There's no such thing as a white Zin grape.
The real Zinfandel, where you take the whole grape rather than just a little bit for the
exactly
color.
Skin and everything.
Didn't know that. All right, so this is clear. It's got a good aroma. I've never had a Zinfandel that's that smooth and well-rounded and good.
This is spicy, huh?
Yeah, I can taste it.
All right. This wine here is 60% Tempranillo and 40% Grenache. They're both our grapes. It's a little bit darker, you notice?
Yeah. In Austria, we say zum wohl. To health.
You want smoothness.
Well, you definitely got it with that one. This is the 2019 Tempranillo.
Right.
And there's no bitterness, no bad aftertaste.
We noticed that we use big bottles, punts,
yeah,
on the bottles. This is a Malbec.
And you do all your own bottling and everything here, too.
We do everything
here. This, you can see, it's still clear, but it definitely has that more like purplish hue. Still full-bodied and not bitter. Oh, and then it's got an afternote too, that kind of sweet kick at the end. That's delicious. After one of the best wine tastings of my life, buying a couple bottles and a glass as well, that was great. Now we're headed to Denver. I was gonna go to a place called Tent Rocks, which is back here off my shoulder, that Raymond recommended, but unfortunately they're closed due to COVID, so it's back onto the I-25 and up to Denver. Followed road signs to Las Vegas, and I can confirm this is definitely Las Vegas, New Mexico. I have to pull over because we're like in a cloud. That's lightning going on right now. Wow. To give you an idea, this is how bad it is. Everybody is stopping on the highway. None of us can see. And it's a really, really good thing that I got my windshield wipers fixed this morning. Pro tip, always carry an empty water bottle. Finally starting to see sun again to come out of this massive thunderstorm though. You might be wondering why I'm wearing a collared shirt and dress slacks. Well, inquisitive viewer, that is a great question. The answer is because today I have to do a little bit of adulting. I'm going to Flight Safety International. I actually, in the before times, was sent out there back in January by an airline and had ordered a luggage tag. Well, another bucket list item done. I got my luggage tag from Flight Safety, which I've wanted forever since I became a pilot. And thank you, Nick, for making these today and not making me wait 1 to 2 days. I'm in a restaurant called Flight Co. Brewing Company right now in Denver, and Emily Little, who's a pilot I know, recommended this place a long, long time ago, and I finally made it down. It's all airplane themed. The owners are actually pilots, so we're in good company here.
One of the three owners here at Flight Co. Brewing. Flight Co. is an aviation themed brewery here in Northwest Denver on 38th and Tennyson. My business partner and I, Jason Slingsby, have been home brewing for about over 10 years now. Talked about airplanes while we brewed beer throughout the year, so it's just kind of a natural theme when we decided to go pro. It is the scale of a 737 size fuselage. We definitely attract the aviation crowd. We give discounts to anyone in the aviation industry, whether you're a pilot, flight attendant, mechanic, engineer, we'll give you a 10% off.
Well, I got a certificate to show you.
Yep. Okay, yeah. I'm Eric Serrani. You can email me at Eric, E-R-I-C, at flightco, F-L-Y-T-E-C-O, dot beer. Not dot com.
Dot beer. Yeah. I like it. This is delicious. It's easy to see why they've gotten so many write-ups and why this is so popular. I got a discount for being a pilot. Anybody in the aviation industry, like you mentioned, gets a discount. So here's the merchandise wing. It's a literal Hershey bar wing, but this is a merchandise wing of Flight Co. And you know you found your people when their hats are not only awesome, but they have your favorite slogan to students in there. The pilot Emily that I told you guys about actually has this display in here for lady aviators. And every sale here, part of it goes to the nonprofit. So what I'm also gonna do is buy a coaster for Flight Co. Brewing. I was hanging out with the guys for a little bit. Now I'm running the I Am Safe checklist. The beer's plenty worn off by now and I'm good to go. And in the meantime, I got to support the Lady Aviators and Flight Co. Brewing here in Colorado. I found a great spot here in the Rockies to do a little bit of quick hiking. How does an axle just fall off? The Dodges just do that?
No, I just...
Here we are at the Grand Junction Airport, and this is exactly why I keep a spare pilot headset in my car, because Brian and I just decided that we're going flying.
Yeah, so we met during flight training, and you were getting your double eye add-on, and I was in the double eye class as well, and so pretty much that's how we got to hanging out, I think.
Taking the 182, which is a high performance airplane.
Fly out to Mac. We're gonna go check out our little Hawk Aviators group, get a quick tour of things out there, and kind of give a briefing on what we've got building and our projects that are currently happening.
1987, I was doing a lot of building and flying with my grandfather at the time, so that turned into a Christmas gift one year, and I had flight lessons, I had access to an airplane. All I had to do was pay for the fuel. And so I think my private pilot's license cost about $600 off
the road. How fast is the wind right now?
Beard says it's about 10 or 12 knots.
Yep, your beard would be right.
Do you think you being young and learning kind of tied into your passion for teaching young kids now?
That's probably, I mean, that's a lot of what it came into. Or the group of folks that were involved with Hawk Aviators, or High Country Aviation Workshop for Kids. It's all for the kids and getting somebody that does not have access normally to, you know, airplanes, aircraft, or personnel or people to even talk about, because
right.
You're sitting here on the other side of the fence just peering through that chain link fence going, you know, what do I do now?
Mm-hmm. You ready for a departure brief?
Ready for a departure brief.
We have 2,400 feet of runway. We need 1,700 feet for takeoff and a 50-foot obstacle.
This is one of our projects here. It's a Zenith 701.
Rotax engine? Nice.
Rotax engine. It came with a Continental C85 that was souped up.
Also got the pedestal wings with the movable wing slats. These are performing.
These aircraft. Are actual stole aircraft.
So there's not very many of the pedestal wing systems out there with the movable slats.
This one came to us from Cal Poly. Donated by Kurt Cobain.
Like the Kurt Cobain?
No, he was a physics professor out there.
Oh, this is a Cherokee then.
This is our Cherokee 140. It's our primary trainer. Right now we're going through the process of soliciting for a new engine. We're looking for the 160 horse. The paint job, of course, was donated by West Star Aviation.
We saw their paint hanger a second ago.
And they let the kids come in and do the work on it as well with them. this Dakota Hawk here is another one of ours. It's actually flown to Oshkosh.
Okay.
By Doc Coleman.
That's a long flight for this plane.
It was. Man, I'll tell you what, it was one of his hoorahs. Sonics aircraft are a very good kit. Now, Tim, being the machinist and designer and fabricator that he is, he came up with this wingtip design based off the Prandtl theory. And it really finishes out the airplane.
I just realized, Brian, we match.
Did you
notice
shirts,
that?
Yeah.
And here we, you know, hold our meetings. We hold our ground lessons.
What'd you think about that flight and that landing?
That was money.
Yeah.
That was some money.
And these are the firefighting aircraft right behind me. These are some Australian bush pilot dudes in the agriculture tankers right here. This is normally what you drop pesticides on farms with, but right now they're using them for fire relief.
Look at that.
Now on to the brewing company. Trip has really just been serene. It's been just me. I've been traveling solo, and like I said, it was the best impulse decision to just get in my car and drive. I spun the compass. I'm only here at Sandia because the windshield wiper broke, and that just kind of goes to show that through all this quarantine, through this COVID stuff, our world has changed. The only thing we can plan for is the unplanned, the unexpected, and just know it's going to happen. But I can tell you, it is not always a bad thing. Look at these views. Just it's been so great. I can't even put into words what this experience has been like. It's been so much personal growth. Overall, just a really, really cool experience. So I would highly recommend all you guys do the same thing safely. Obviously, plan it out. You know, look at a map, learn some basic survival skills, get some supplies and equipment, but just go. I did this whole thing for the cost of gas. And I mean, you've seen some of the places I've gone, some of the people I've met, it's really cool. Pie Town, USA, who knew? I got pie there. Even as an av geek, I can see the Albuquerque airport down there. This has been such a fantastic experience. So seriously, if you guys have never done this, road trip alone, go buy a random plane ticket, do something, go camping, right? Anything, get in touch with nature, get in touch with yourself. If you have any questions, leave a comment below or wherever you're watching this, above, sideways, leave a comment. Let me know if you have any questions. If I have experience with it, I'll answer. If not, I'll refer you to some great sites or resources. Thank you guys so much for watching this video this far, and hope to do many more like it.